Would do you have any, speaking of car, my son is 11 months and he still hates the car seat. Hates it. Any ideas?
What position is the car seat in?
So facing the back.
Okay, rear facing.
Yeah.
Have you tried white noise in the car?
We have the white noise, like a little to-go one that hangs there. We have toys. We have like the thing that he looks at. And our dog is always in the car with him. So he's got like a friend right there.
Yeah. Have you tried rolling down the windows? Just one window where it makes that noise?
Rolling down the window, get the noise, get the air going.
Yeah. Some just don't like it.
No, yep. He just doesn't like it.
No. Nope. How old is he? 11?
11 months. Yeah.
Yeah. TV.
Thank you. Okay. We'll hope he grows out of that.
Yeah.
Question on here from a user who just sent in. She said, what if my baby only naps for 30 minutes and absolutely hates the carrier?
Yep. That happens. Sleep shaping is like a gentle form of sleep training, and it's using their natural sleep habits to teach them to sleep longer. A lot of times with those babies, I'll see them sleep in chunks. So we'll put them down for a nap. They'll sleep for 30 minutes, they'll wake up. And a lot of parents will think that it's ready to get up when actually you can put them back to sleep. So you have to teach them that it's not time to wake up yet. So soothe them just like you would at the beginning of the nap and put them back to sleep.
So for example, if the baby's in the crib napping and wakes up, do you recommend taking the baby out of the crib and soothing them? Or do you recommend trying to do like a hand on the chest and rocking them in the crib?
Crib side soothing. So put your hand in the bed, shushing over the crying, rocking gently, and then putting them back to sleep.
Okay. So try and extend that 30. Don't assume the 30 minutes is a get up time.
Right. And it might be just changing a swaddle. There might be a swaddle that's better suited for your baby. There's lots of different swaddle options now. There's some that have like beans that go on their chest to kind of help them feel secure, like a weighted blanket. A double swaddle sometimes will help a baby sleep longer. So playing with the swaddles, I found, can help babies sleep longer.
Interesting.
They might need something a little bit different. If they're like a finger sucker, then they might need to have one hand swaddled and one hand out. Babies that roll early might need their arms out, but not really know what to do with them. That's what I was actually working with today. And we're teaching the baby that to sleep with their hands up. So we're just like putting gentle pressure on their hands and they're in the crib so that they know that this is where your hands are comfortable because you like them there. And as soon as we taught him that skill, he went to sleep.
Awesome.
So just working with what you have already.
Lauren, I don't know. That was your question. If there's any follow-up you want on that, feel free to unmute and jump in at any time. But that's a good, so she also added that her baby hates the carrier. Are there recommendations on do you try and stimulate in the carrier? Would you recommend trying different carriers? Any carriers you find work better?
Yeah, probably a different type of carrier. And is the position on the carrier correct? Because sometimes if you're twisted, it would be uncomfortable. It'd be like wearing clothes that are twisted.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Awesome. That's helpful. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Anyone else who has questions on the call, definitely feel free to jump in. But I will go to one that we had.
Recommendation for a carrier. Okay. I love mine. I've had it this is my second child with them. It's the Inferno. It doesn't require an insert. So it actually like snaps smaller at between the legs. So it could use it up 8 pounds all the way up to 40 pounds. So you can back carry. So I was back carrying my now 3-year-old for a while. Now it's just too heavy to be back there, even though it can have him back there. But it's great because it snaps a little and it doesn't have the insert, which I found was heating my heating them up. And so they didn't like that extra heat. Mm-hmm. But the Moby wraps are also another big favorite just because they can get all snuggly in there too. But I find her too big to get into the Moby now. Inferno was my absolute favorite.
Yeah. That's cool. I haven't heard of them. The Moby I think is great, but Nicky and I both live in Florida, and that is hot in Florida. I had to go to linen ring slings because that was the only thing that I wasn't like sweating through while using it.
Yeah, I love a ring sling.
I'm obsessed. It's like the only thing I use. I love it.
I've also in Florida, I've used a water carrier, a mesh. So it's a mesh carrier.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
And I've had an August baby, and that was the only carrier that she would go in because it was so hot.
My son was July, and I have a mesh ring sling.
Yes.
And I would like wade into the water with him.
Yeah.
It was great. Yeah.
Yeah. We just use our water sling all the time.
Yeah. It's huge down here. Tara, I saw that you just unmuted. Did you have a carrier or a question?
Oh, sorry. It was just that my baby was waking up. but I do have an Ergo baby carrier, and that's been so comfortable. That seems to be like super supportive for my back. I think it's the Ergo Baby 360. And similar to the Mobi wrap, I have one of those wraps too. It's like an off-brand one, but that though seems to put my baby to sleep immediately. So,
and a lot of times I've noticed with parents that think their baby doesn't like the carrier, it might be more of the mom being anxious, putting the baby in the carrier, and the baby kind of feeds off that anxiousness that the mom might be expressing internally, even if she seems calm on the outside. So just checking and making sure that you're calm on the inside, like doing some deep breaths before putting your baby in, and reminding yourself that your baby is safe, that you're putting your baby in the carrier safe, will make the baby feel more secure, and they might actually like the carrier more.
That makes sense. Lauren, I don't know how old your baby is, but I would say my baby did not like when I sat in a chair at the computer with him in the carrier at first. And a friend of mine gave me the great idea of sitting on like a blow up ball because it bounced ever so slightly. Yep. And then he loved the carrier. So when I was sitting in a desk chair, he hated it. When I sat on the ball, he loved it. Yep. And it helped repair my abs after birth. So it's a win-win on that one.
Yeah, that's a good suggestion.
Perfect.
Okay, thank you.
Of course.